Welcome, you're watching Editor's Take. This is Vaibhavi Khanwalkar. We're talking about Jet Airways and the airline inching its way towards a resolution plan with the help of its stakeholders and the lenders. We've got Prince Thomas with us to tell us more about the developments. Hi, Prince. Hi. Welcome. There's a lot that has been happening at Jet in the past few months. What is the latest news coming in from there?
So on Wednesday, SBI, the lead lender of Jet Airways, had called for an emergency meeting. And in that meeting, both Jet Airways, Naresh Goyal, and Tony Douglas of Etihad were present. And now we believe that there was some urgency because Jet Airways is not in a very comfortable position. But we believe that a breakthrough hasn't happened. Okay. Because even though Naresh Goyal has agreed to step down and he possibly may vacate the post of chairman also, Etihad has put forward a lot of conditions. And it wants the banks to first clear and act on the resolution plan before it comes with any money. Okay. So that's where the talks are right now. We would believe that there would be a second round of meeting, possibly next week. Mm. And that would be really important, that's crucial, because time is really running out for Jet Airways.
Right. But Prince, we've been seeing that in the news also, this has been going on for a while. Why is it that the deal is taking so much time?
So it's interesting because till now it was about Naresh Goyal stepping down, because that was the condition that Etihad had put in. Also, the banks were keen that there was an operational change in the company. Now that Goyal has agreed to it, it is Etihad which is kind of holding up the deal. Okay. It has put in a lot of conditions, like we mentioned before. One was about Goyal ceding control, which has happened, but it wants a lot of waiver of conditions for its investment in Jet. And plus, it wants the banks to be more proactive. On the other hand, banks want to make sure that both Etihad and Goyal also bring in some money.
Right, okay. So then what does this mean for Jet?
So that's the critical part, because Jet is losing ground. Mm-hmm. Like we reported, it has already grounded about one third of its fleet. It cancelled over 300 flights over February and March. Right. And just as we reported now, its market share is also going down. And the salary payment issue with the pilots, engineers continue. So it's a very precarious situation for Jet, and time is of the essence now. It needs urgent infusion of funds. Otherwise, the morph of its aircraft could be grounded going forward. Right. So very critical now.
We'll just have to see how it goes forward.
Yes.
Thank you so much for those insights, Prince. With that, it's a wrap on this edition of Editor's Take. For more such news and views, stay logged on to moneycontrol.com. Thanks for watching.